Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji. In the previous videos, we created rebars for beams, columns, shear wall, and so on. In this video, we're gonna get one rebar schedule such as this one. So I'm gonna delete this and start again. How about I go to view? The schedules are here, schedules and quantities. I wanna just put one S, so it's gonna take me to structural menus, and it's gonna be structural rebar or rebar schedule, okay. So let's see what's good to include. How about we consider the count, the number, and I would like to know the type, whether it's like 22M or 19M. I want to also know the length and the quantity, so I want to put the quantity on that side, so it's going to tell me how much I have from each type. And finally the length, because usually the rebar's cost is mentioned per length, so I'm going to also need the length. It's actually this one, total bar length. So I want to move it over there. So let's see how it works right now. So now you see we have a very big list here. And I want to narrow it down a little bit. So one of the things I would like to do is to go to edit under sorting and grouping. I would like to remove itemize every instance. Okay, this is not exactly what I wanted. So let's go to edit, work with the schedule properties to get the right thing. How about we also go to sort by under sorting and grouping. And I want to change this to type. So it's going to sort them based on the type. Now you see it's getting better. Next, I would like to go to the menus again. This time I want to use grand totals. And now you see the number is added here. We can keep going. We can go here, go with formatting. And for the count, I want to show totals. Calculate totals. Also for the quantity, I want to show totals as well as the total bar length. Okay, now you see the number is giving me basically the number of each of these types, but for each type there is a higher quantity. So let me show you how it works. How about I go to my 3D view, grab everything, and I just want to filter all the elements except for the rebars. So I want to check known, and I want to go to search our rebars, get them from here, as well as model groups, because I modeled some of them already. Okay, and I want to go to isolate category. So this is all the rebars that we have here. I just created the rebar for one of the beams, but if you want to be inclusive, you need to do it for all the beams. So for instance, here if I click on one of these rebars for the columns, you see it says 25M, but it's actually more than one because it considers the whole thing, right? So if I use WT to put the views side by side, for 25, M, which is this one, that's where you see the number for the count is different than the number for quantity. So it means that if I have 28 of these, because I have 28 columns. But if we consider all the columns combined, it's not going to be 28, it's going to be actually 8847. So the real quantity is here, it's not 205. And if you check the website for some of the manufacturers, they usually mention the price per length. So usually it's different per meter for each type. That's why it's important that when you go to the schedule, you need to actually sort it by type, because the prices are usually different for each type. Yeah, it's good to remove the itemize every instance, but keep the grand totals. Also under formatting for the count, as well as for the quantity and total bar length, is always good to have the calculate totals. So let's import this schedule into Excel. We can go to File, under Export. We have Reports here, and I'm interested to get the schedule. So I'm gonna save this here. It's gonna be as a text file. Okay. I'm gonna copy this text file. So let's paste the table here. And I want to remove the 2m from here. So it's gonna know these values as numbers. This is total bar length in millimeters. I want to get the total bar length in meters. So it's gonna be this number divided by 1000. If you want to decrease the numbers after the point, we can use this option. And maybe we already know the cost per meter. So this is gonna be cost per unit of length in meters. Maybe 16 millimeter here is $0.9 per meter. This is 1.1, 1.2, and maybe 1.5 here. So we can calculate the cost by multiplying this times this. I want to add one more column here. I want to name this as total. And I want to get the total values here. And for these numbers, you can go to format cell. We can change this to currency, that all looks good. So in this case, and let me change the colors here. If we have this price for a unit of length, the total value is gonna add up to about $34,000.